What's up? We here with the first freaking rebuild. The biggest change to the Falcons organization is they decide to let Arthur Smith go. Arthur Smith was a good hire, but there was no good available coaches at the time. Let's be honest. So, with that being said, welcome to your franchise Falcons staff. General manager decides to go out and get Marcus Spears and hire him. Now, as far as offensive coordinators go, I think we're going to hire Lamont Booker. Looks pretty good. So, that being said, you guys are going to see a lot in this episode. A lot of changes coming to the Falcons organization. Come this offseason, a lot of trades are going to be happening. We are in a complete rebuild. Matt Ryan, he's going to go to a different organization because he's good, but I believe for what we're trying to do moving forward, I don't think he's going to be a part of this team because his Super Bowl window is closing. It's closing. So, with that being said, we're going to go to this offseason. We're going to make some cap space because I don't know how much cap space. We have $14.8 million in cap space, so we need to make some changes happen. We're not going to draft a quarterback this year because I believe we have our guy. Our guy we're going to go with, you guys are going to see in a second. I think if we can't get a corner in the trade, we might end up drafting a corner. So, gonna go ahead, add Ahmad Gardner there. Derek Stingley, of course, he's gonna be a top pick. We might draft Derek Stingley. I think we're going to draft Derek Stingley if we can get a top pick. But Ahmad Gardner is what it's looking like we're probably going to be with. Jordan Davis might be the guy I go after. Jordan Davis, that's a big boy from Georgia, plays for Georgia, and like, We're going to make something happen. Let's say that. Make some things happen. That's what we're about to do. So y'all sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. First things first, you retirement. See who retired. Mercedes Lewis retired. That's expected. He's getting older. Mitchell Schwartz. Roger Saffold, Andrew Whitworth. These boys have some successful careers. 12 years, 13 years, 13 years. Yes. Andy Lee, 18 years. So I expect some of these. They have double-digit years on them. So let them go ahead. We'll respect them all. Let's see who we're going to decide to keep. These players are on the last year of their contract. We're definitely going to keep Young Waiku. I want to do that. Young Waiku, you are a great kicker. He is a great kicker, so probably keep him. Russell Gage, I think we're going to let him walk. Fabian Moreau, we're going to let him walk. Of course, a lot of these guys we're gonna let walk just because I think the only person we'll end up signing not only signing but keeping is Cordell Patterson. You were good, but
this is the development trade. This is the abilities tab.
Okay, sir. Guess we'll franchise tag him. Doesn't want to play, but guess what? You're forced to play another year. First of all, let's go ahead and show y'all what we're getting ready to get into. I love Calvin Ridley. Totally love him. But unfortunately, we're going to be looking for a trade partner. Matt, hey, let's see what the Giants do. I think Matt Ryan retired. Let's see what happened with Matt Ryan. Is he on the injury report or? So, what happened to Matt Ryan? I'm trying to figure out what happened to Matt Ryan. Ryan decides to retire. Didn't even see that coming. Totally did not see that coming. I was gonna trade him, but I guess we're definitely gonna be in the market for a quarterback now. Calvin, I love you, but I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we were sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claim me, you my dog, and then you hold on me. Nowadays, they ain't showing real loyalty. I was walking down the dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we were sliding in that four door Audi. When the smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came my number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody.
body, better ask me for none. Remember we were sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hotter, make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.
Cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go.
Pop out, treat this block like an end zone. What? Score. Check it. Benji calling money, my return.
So we gonna see something.
Take one for the team. My boy.
Let's see who rejects our offer so far. First.
I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man. I bet we win it. Go hard or go home, it's survival of the fittest.
Let's get activated, let's get activated. Let's get activated, let's get activated. QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real.
That's fine, cuz.
Put me in the gun, I know what to do. That's another sack, cuz I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
We're gonna probably most likely gonna end up sending Calvin Ridley to the AFC, because I do not want to have to worry about playing him. I think we'll end up keeping Calvin. Oh, these two are going to be some game changers. Frank Clark and Derek Barnett. Grady Jarrett, I'm sorry, but you're probably going to end up being with Jordan Davis. We're going to try to run a 4-3 defense this season. And yeah.
What you see is good intentions, it's for cloud and hit is mad. You can never be a
I probably should sign a quarterback just because I need one. Who do I believe will be a good mentor? Nick Foles. Falcons decide to go ahead with Cam Newton. See if they can get some with Cam. Hate when this thing does that. EA wants to keep signing me out. I want this team. I want our strength to really be our defense. They really want Gardner Minshew, huh? We'll make Dante Fowler. We'll trade next year's third rounder for Garner. And they accept it, so welcome to Team Garner. And oh yeah, we're gonna get AJ Dillon. Mike Davis is good and all, but AJ Dillon is. Whew. I'll be back, just chill for a minute. Welcome AJ Dillon for a second round pick. I'm feeling pretty good about what this team can do. This team's gonna do some real damage. Let's go ahead and start this draft. Jaguars are now on the clock. Okay, it's the Lions now on the clock. That's surprising, seeing they got seeing that they have Trevor Lawrence, that's surprising that they would draft a QB.
On the clock now, it's the Texans.
Lions, good pick. Kayvon Thibodeau.
Next up,
Spencer Rattler for the Texans. I guess they don't believe in their guy.
Okay, the Giants up now. They're on the clock.
Pretty good picks happening. Evan Neal gone. Kyle Hamilton. Let's see who the Panthers decide to get.
And the Giants now
Chris Olave. Good pick.
The Falcons are now on the clock.
Are you serious? We get the eighth pick, and guess who's available to us? Oh, yes. Welcome to the Falcons, Derek. 95 speed, 93 acceleration. Oh my gosh, that's going to be great for our defense. This defense.
Jets now on the clock.
Now, let's cross our fingers and hope
all right, next up, the football team
that
on the clock.
Jordan Davis will the still be available.
Now, what direction will they go? And the Browns on the clock now. Let's see what direction they go. The Ravens are up now. Let's see what direction they go.
Kind of want to just
now, it's the Falcons.
I say the only way you could keep Gardner Minshew upright is by drafting a lineman. So
okay, it's the Falcons now on the clock.
When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I feel.
The Packers are now on the clock.
We're a drafted lineman, man. We gotta protect Gardner. We're making some smart picks because we gotta protect Gardner before anything. Good. Oh man. Broncos are on. Go ahead, pick Zach Pickens. You got a star. You got a.
Next up, the Falcons are on the clock.
A lot of players are going to get position switch. I didn't draft a safety because I honestly think, as a matter of fact, wait till after this draft. You guys will see. You guys will get to see what we're going to do, what roster, what positions we're going to move around. Some people will be playing different positions. So this season is going to be definitely interesting. But let's go ahead and see our draft recap. See Derek Stingley, 81 overall. Pretty good draft. Got a lineman at a 73. Had a lineman at a 73, D3. Got a lineman at a 68. So these boys is definitely going to be good. Right tackle at 61 as a rookie. Marcus Spears had a good, pretty good draft. Now let's go to the preseason.
When DeMarcus Ware was selected 11th overall in the two.
Trying to be friendly, it is what it is. If you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, don't it confetti. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more.
Jake Matthews most likely end up playing center.
From 0 to 90, if you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it.
I really want to see how long, how much longer is Chris Godwin out for. 3 weeks. He'll be ready by the start of the season. Telling you, Dante Jackson, we're gonna leave that speed. We're gonna let that speed go crazy. How long is Julius Peppers out for? 3 weeks, so our guys will be back. Love you a little, Con, but we signed Reuben Foster so that you can play Robe. And then Like I said, Grady Jarrett play full time inside. Tell you, Marcus Spears knows what he's doing with this team. Stingley with that speed at punt return, that's gonna be a fun one. Now let's go ahead and see how fun this team is gonna be.
Gardner Minshew, sixth round selection in 2019 out of Washington State. Minshew, first and 10. He's got his pass catching tight end. That's Pitts. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down. Off play action, it's Minshew. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley.
Boy, Gardner Minshew got a good drive going on now.
Get across midfield. They'll go play action here with Minshew. Now swing pass for Dylan. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. It really gets them amped up as they go forward.
22 yards there, a first down. They'll run with a big back, A.J. Dillon. And they corral him.
Wow, this team has a successful first drive.
So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
Well, I think the hope is, you know, with a touch pass like that, maybe you catch the defense off guard, but they were all over that one.
And it is the kind of play that works better against certain defenses, and this clearly was the wrong one to run into. Really nice job getting him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Driven him down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. And that sack brings up fourth and goal, a loss of seven. Big play.
Well, that was a good, successful drive, but...
And this one is right through. And the Falcons are out to a 3-0 advantage.
Comes out to 3 points.
So it remains to be seen how many drives this unit gets in, this being the preseason, but here they start with 3 points.
Yeah, I don't know that we'll actually see them anymore. They got 3 points on the board, one drive here in preseason in this game. baseball caps, NFL approved, of course, for everyone.
Now a hit and a loose football. Now a hit and a loose football.
That Falcons special teams is going crazy in the preseason.
And that one is his second fumble loss. Not a good look out of your return man.
And not only does he hurt the momentum for his team or even change momentum of the game, but now they've got a decision to make on his own sideline. Does he continue to do that?
Garner Minshew being smart. Nobody open downfield.
He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Now Minshew. Well, that'll be incomplete.
The pressure got there.
As he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and five. And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And he's going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and ten. Minshew sets to throw. Getting this ball out wide for Davis. Touchdown, Falcons! Mike Davis,
at 18. Garner Minshew's looking good so far, you know.
On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Just a terrific run there, Charles, for a running back who is so compact and powerful. And that strength was on display there. Derrick Henry. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. A nice run there, 9 yards. And it'll be second down. Second quarter now, Titans in possession of the football. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. Now it's the backup, Rudolph. Incomplete. By the way, I gotta apologize because I just realized for about the last 4 or 5 plays I'm eking over in your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm gonna get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm gonna try to tighten things up here for this next play. On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. A good job in the passing game, decent job in the running game, but really they've been more effective. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Porter Gustin. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
Like the footwork back there. I thought he did a pretty good job of evading that first wave of players. Tried to buy a little extra time out of the pocket, but in the end, oh, that was a tough one.
Yeah, winds up getting buried for the loss. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. It'll be a loss of 8 on the sack, and it's going to lead him to fourth down. The Falcons send out their punter as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Now a hit and a loose football.
I'm telling you, this Falcons special teams might be the strength of this team.
I don't know why, but it's always agonizing to me to see a guy make a mistake in this phase of the game, because you could it's all on him. All eyes there. He's got a chance to make the punt return, and instead he ends up putting it on the carpet.
Puts it on the carpet. The little rubber pellets shoot up.
Cam.
Good sign for a returner on this field turf surface.
No, not at all. And a bunch of them go up when they're all trying to get to the football, don't they?
Stop short of the 25. The second effort couldn't free him. haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. A dump off for Davis. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
From the five, second and four. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. The Falcons on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10. So give them 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And it'll be fourth down. They snap it to Newton. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A disappointing drop there on fourth and goal. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. On first down, they'll start out with Evans. And he's going to take this up past the 10 to about the 11. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Here's Rudolph. Got this complete to Racy McMath. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. 10-0 our score. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 32. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
I know some teams are leery about playing cover two because a strong safety is not usually a terrific cover guy. But in this case, he played it perfectly. Read the football and went and made the interception.
A hit as he throws there, incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Newton now to throw. And that is caught. It's Davis. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
And a good job here of getting the running backs involved in the passing game because they line him up out in the slot to the right. And they're hoping he won't get accounted for, and he's not. Turns into big trouble for the defense, able to work his way free, and turns it into a big play.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. Throwing again on second and 10. Newton. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And they have possession, and they have it at the 35.
It's kind of why we just want Cam to be a mentor to Minshew. I believe Cam.
Something about whittling it to a one-score game. Rudolph loses the football. It's out. And the Falcons say they have it.
I believe Cam could be a good alternate. I think it's time to see Felipe Franks. What Felipe Franks brings to the team.
You know, if this is the regular season, partner, we'd be talking about just how costly a mistake that was, but probably good for him to get it out of his system right now.
Just hope for him and the team it's not a sign of things to come.
Yeah, without a doubt. Plus, gotta worry about making the team. Those types of errors don't help you.
A big connection on that one. 31 yards.
A lot of running backs in the passing game, they're just used to check it down to them or maybe dump off passes. This guy.
And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. A great play there.
Felipe Franks just totally comes out and just likes.
Rudolph on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And it looked like he got the feet down, did he? Yes, it's a catch. Touchdown, Titans. Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years. On on first and 10. Franks. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. So we have a rough crowd. No football for 6 months already. We're skipping halftime. All right, let's get right back to the action. We're set for quarter three. Third quarter starts with a run by Chris Evans. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life out on the field, don't they? And we just saw that on that outside handoff to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to dominate his guy and say, listen, I was the point of attack. I took care of business. That's why you're able to get downfield and add all those yards to your total.
Yeah, really nice gain there. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Rudolph looking to throw it. The catch made by Pharaoh Cooper. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
Now Rudolph on first down. And he's got his big tight end here. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
Many different ways
I may need to sign someone to kickstart this defense, because, like, these boys is reading everything, but they're not trying to.
On first and 10, it's Evans. A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Evans gets it again on second down. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Darrington Evans. First down throw. Here's Franks escaping the pressure right. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. A big play.
Felipe Franks will learn. He got a lot to learn.
Throwing after the interception. Franks. He'll get this complete into the hands of Riley Ridley. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. Now Mike Vrabel unsure of that last. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. A good first down call as the screenplay gets him 9. They go play action with Franks. Over the middle, that's caught by Ridley. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. Franks now.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over, and they got there to break that one up. The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Working out of the gun, Franks. Flush to it. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. This is caught. They'll wind up getting 7 on the completion, but they'll still be faced now with a 3rd and goal situation. Franks. touchdown from 3 yards out. And the Falcons have retaken. On first and 10, Rudolph. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Out of the gun, a give to Evans. Back now here on EA Sports. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more preseason football on EA Sports. Now a throw here to his running back. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
And they'll wind up getting this one.
How did he catch that?
Inside the 20.
I don't believe he caught that. That's some Madden juice. Because he just mossed him.
They'll run on first down with Evans. And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still. Gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And it's a Titans touchdown. From 13 yards out. On first down, here's Franks. And this one is incomplete.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one. The Falcons on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 10. Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a 4th down. Well done.
The Falcons send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. It's a 45-yard punt, just a 1-yard return, and it'll be Titan football. They'll begin on the ground with Evans, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
These boys are fighting for their job, so...
Incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way way out there, but it'll be 3rd down. Throwing on 3rd down, here's Rudolph. And that is incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
It has to be a little frustrating.
Franks now to throw on 1st down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Gary and Conley. Gets around him, and they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
I'm not sure I'm absolutely crazy about that play call there. I mean, it's only a 1-score game, so is it really time to go bombs away and try and make a big play? I think you can take some underneath stuff and still move it downfield.
After the interception, here's Rudolph. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And the Titans are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they search for what could be a game-sealing touchdown. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Again, it'll be Evans. And he will score! Touchdown, Titans! Darrington Evans. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Falcons. Riley Ridley, 75 yards. And the Falcons have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So a big play coming for the Falcons as they'll go for two. Here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a two-point conversion, but still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do, and don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he had hands, he'd be playing on offense.
Oh, that's true. You said that before. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that...
Oh, no, he lost the football. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. So they keep the football, but now face second and long. A give running right is Evans. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. And they'll indeed take a knee. Here's Brett Kern now as he's on to punt for Tennessee. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. Atlanta regains possession of the football. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still...